We are into the New Year movie preview, in which we're looking at 20 film releases that will be trending in the 6 weeks right up until Valentine's Day. So, what better way to see in the new year than, of course, at the movies? And it's awards season, which means, as always, the leading Oscar and BAFTA contenders will be opening in this period. So, the first of my 20 features Colin Firth, no stranger to award ceremonies. He stars as Eric Lomax in the title role of the Railway Man. In World War II, Lomax was a prisoner of war working on the Burma-Thai Railway. The torture he suffered haunts him for years, even after he meets his wife Patty, played by Nicole Kidman, until he gets the chance to meet up again with his Japanese torturer. Jeremy Irvine gives a brave performance as the young Eric who endures so much. So let's take a look at an early scene from the Railway Man. Right now.
Major. Major York. The Russians have retaken Stalingrad. Got them on the run, sir. Hitler on the run. That's it, sir. And we're bombing Germany 24 hours a day. So now the US Air Force has joined in.
The men, sir. Right? You've got to let them know it's going our way.
At number 19, we're back in the land of Paranormal Activity, the franchise that just rolls on. But this is a slightly different take on the Paranormal Activity franchise. It's a film called The Marked Ones, which offers a rather scary change of direction for this series. If you find yourself marked with bite-like impressions on your skin, you've actually been possessed by a mysterious spirit.
Let's go check downstairs.
Holy, there's blood everywhere.
Katie and Christy.
What is this? This is some black magic stuff.
Hey.
She's got pictures of you. How does she have pictures of you?
Dude, I had the craziest dreams. Check it out.
What is it?
It looks like a bite or something.
Your behavior starts to change if you've got these bite marks on you from what your family and friends expect. If you have a taste for the suspense, this should be right up your street. On to numbers 18 and then 17, two very different Hollywood comedies opening in early January. The first is Delivery Man. It's a tricky dilemma for all the guys in the audience. How would you feel if you've been a sperm donor for a fertility clinic for 20 years? One day you find out you've not only fathered 500 children, but 100 of them want to know who their dad is. That's the problem facing Vince Vaughn alongside Kobe Smulders, who are the cast in this one set in New York. We're then across the state in Las Vegas. Three friends throw a stag party for their remaining single friend before he gets married. The twist being this time, they're all over 60. The friends are played by Michael Douglas, Kevin Klein, Morgan Freeman, and Robert De Niro. So the one thing we might expect is colossal hangovers.
Hey, look, don't be upset with him, Pat. It wasn't your fault. Hey, look. I'm getting married, okay? This is a bachelor party. I needed you there.
I'm going home.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, how many times do I gotta tell you I'm sorry?
You can't say it enough, my friend. You can't say it
Every
enough.
Every time I see you, we go through the same
old... One more word, I'm gonna knock your block off like I did when we were in the fifth grade.
Oh, yeah, that's the way you are.
Hey, knock it off.
Next up is number 16, and it stars the mighty Idris Elba. Of course, I'm talking about Mandela, Long Walk to Freedom, based on the late leader's autobiography. This event status film, directed by Justin Chadwick, chronicles Mandela's life from rural childhood to inauguration as the first elected black president of his country, South Africa. There are lots of insights, too, into the less well-chronicled life of Winnie Mandela, brilliantly played, and she is truly fantastic in this movie by Naomi Harris. At number 15, it's 12 Years a Slave, set in pre-Civil War America. Steve McQueen directs Chiwetel Ejiofor as Solomon Northup, a free black man from New York who is kidnapped and sold into slavery. His fight for survival is even more extraordinary when you think that Solomon Northup was a real man, and the film is a true story based on his book. Benedict Cumberbatch, Brad Pitt, and Michael Fassbender, a veteran of Steve McQueen's earlier movies Hunger and Shame, also appear. Benedict Cumberbatch is also my choice in number 14, August, Osage County. It's the story of a strong-willed, dysfunctional family who reunite in Oklahoma when a crisis brings them together. It's got a phenomenal cast. Meryl Streep, Julia Roberts, Juliette Lewis, and Abigail Breslin, alongside Ewan McGregor and Sam Shepard as well.
I thought the services were lovely.
Nobody talked about the good stuff.
She takes pills, Valium, Vicodin, Xanax.
That stunt she pulled. She smuggled a bottle of Darvocet in her.
You want to search me?
No.
Then in my next few films are all in the running for some award nominations in the coming weeks. Best thing to do is go and see, obviously, what you make of them yourselves. At number 13, Inside Llewelyn Davis, the latest from the Coen brothers, Joel and Ethan, who've obviously amassed an astonishingly varied body of work. Set in 1961, the film traces the story of a young folk singer in New York, played by Oscar Isaac, alongside Carey Mulligan, Justin Timberlake, and John Goodman, whose actual career in Coen brothers movies dates back more than 25 years now to Raising Arizona.
Bubble, helmet, flash, guard, boots. Gravity.
Shoot.
That's no place to be a hero.
Okay.
Okay. Hey, look, I'm happy for the gig, but who wrote this?
I did.
Okay?
So, okay.
Good.
Shout.
Please, Mr. Kennedy, take one, and we're rolling.
One, two, three, four.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 second, please.
Now, my number 12, it's The Armstrong Lie, which catapults us headlong into the rise and fall of the cyclist before the doping scandal actually blew up and Armstrong was stripped of his 7 Tour de France victories. But obviously, at that point, the cameras were already in position.
That's where it becomes a game of power. When you can say, I'm signing up Ferrari to be my exclusive doctor. When you can say, I'm going to use a private jet to travel around, to evade detection.
All right, number 11 is The Wolf of Wall Street. Martin Scorsese's stylish drama, reuniting him with Leonardo DiCaprio, who plays a stockbroker in his 20s with all of life's pleasures at his disposal. But inevitably, it turns into a searing modern-day story of fraud, corruption, crime, and punishment. The cast includes Jonah Hill, Matthew McConaughey, and our very own Joanna Lumley.
You know what a Fugazi is?
No, Fugazi. It's a fake.
Hey, Fugazi, Fugazi. It's a wazi, it's a woozy, it's a fairy dust.
Was all this legal? Absolutely not. We were making more money than we knew what to do with.
We don't work for you, man.
Yeah, my money taped to your boobs. Technically, you do work for
me. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been an absolute pleasure doing this show for you this evening. I do hope you enjoyed it.